Hi guys, Dan here. Today I've got a couple of snow blowers that are having problems throwing snow. First up is a Craftsman 27-inch 8 horsepower. Pretty common machine that Murray made for Sears for quite some time. They made it in green and red. All different variations, but basically the same machine. So in this case, the customer said the machine seems to be working, but it just doesn't throw snow. So one of the first things I do is just check the rakes, make sure the pins are good. And then another thing is reach in and give this auger inside impeller a spin. And in this case, you can see that that impeller is spinning without the shaft spinning. So on these Craftsman machines, they use either a quarter inch roll pin in there, or sometimes a quarter inch bolt and a nut. So this one has a quarter inch roll pin in there. So what I do is I just kind of get in the neighborhood, get it lined up. I stuck a little torch tip cleaner through there, and then I got myself kind of in the ballpark. Here's a quarter inch roll pin. It's a hardened steel press pin. And what I'm going to do on it is just to kind of get it started, I'm just going to put a little bit more of a chamfer on it with my Burr King belt grinder here. That's just enough to get it started, to make it start a little bit straighter. Instead of pulling all this stuff out, I actually line up the chute opening with that pin so I can get a small hammer in there. And then I can actually just tap it through and tap out the old broken off piece of the pin by pushing the new pin in place. I've actually done this hundreds of times, and it usually works pretty well. Sometimes on a really old machine, you won't be able to press them through, and you have to take this whole assembly out and really beat it through. But to save some time, I try to do this. And you can see I just pushed the old pin out here. There's an old piece of the roll pin. Pretty simple stuff, and save you a lot of time and aggravation just to fix it yourself. All you need is a hammer and a couple of 50-cent roll pins. So here I've got the pin pushed through on the first hole. There's two holes there. There's one right behind it. And I'm just going to push it through on the second hole. And here you go. I'll show it to you all finished. The pins just stick through. They're about an inch and a quarter long. You can get them from Sears. You can get them at the local hardware store. So now I've got a Toro 826 machine. This is a machine that I personally like myself. It's a 2013 model. It's got the best joystick in the business. It's a single joystick, forward and back, left and right. They always work. They never break. They're really, really durable for a homeowner, and they just work well. They're kind of bulletproof. This has got a Briggs 11.5 foot-pound engine on it, 250cc. And we'll just take a quick look at the Briggs code here. It's a 15 cubic inch. You can see the 15CO104-0156-F8. It was 2011, April, May, January, February, March, April, May it was built. So before I tip this guy back, I'm just going to shut the fuel off, and the engine switches to shut over to off. So I'm not worried about this thing starting up and running itself, which some people seem to be pretty worried about. So I'm going to tip it back. And in these particular machines, they use a quarter inch bolt through there. So what I'm going to do is use a grade 8 quarter inch bolt and get the holes lined up here. You can see this one's broken. And I'm going to grab a set of bolts here. These are all grade 8. Zinc chromate bolts, and I'm looking for one that's going to go through that hub and the shaft with the solid bolt area, against the shaft. So basically, I don't want to have part of the bolt neck there and then part threads there, because the threads aren't as strong as the neck part. So I'm using a bolt that's got a neck that'll go all the way through the shaft and into both ends. So here you see I've got a couple of 7/16 wrenches and a stainless steel nylon lock nut on it. You can really use whatever you want. I just happen to have these stainless ones, and they don't rust so much. So basically just push them through here. thread them up, just snug them up. You don't have to go super crazy on them. Just snug them up, and that's your shear pin for a Toro machine. That's a pretty common repair on those machines. I see them break once in a while. Again, I like this machine. It's light, it's durable, throws well, and it's not too heavy to maneuver around. Thanks for watching.